This is the story of Wilson Rawlings Spaulding, a famous and beloved athlete who lived sometime in the 20th century. Now, you may not recognize him by that name, but I'm sure you will once you've heard the ballad of the rise and fall of Basketball Bill.
He was born in the Knickerbocker locker room. The midwife was a referee. Clutched in his hand was a sneaker size 12. He was dribbling at the age of 3, Lord. Dribbling at the age of 3. Basketball Bill, listen to them roar. Shooting hook shots at the age of 4. He grew to giant economy size, got a scholarship to Notre Dame. Rockwell drew him for the cover of Post. Spaulding was a big time name, yeah, a very, very big time name. Basketball Bill reached his goal, number one on the Gallup poll. But the alumni only paid him $100 a week. Chicken feed for all his fame. So he sought out the man from the mafia. He decided that he'd throw the game. Basketball Bill, Basketball Bill, had his fingers in the till. The fans were stunned as he bobbled the ball.
The fence came rushing in.
They dragged him off to Alcatraz.
He committed an unpopular sin.
Yes, a very unpopular sin. Basketball Bill, serving his time, wrote his memoirs for modern crime. Ooh, ooh.
There's a moral for all young athletes. If it's money that you want to get, don't shave points in a basketball game.
Shave a television for Gillette.